One of my favorite no-code app building tools, Softr, has just released a brand new feature that I think is going to fly under the radar for many, but the few who pick up on it will be able to create the most powerful and fastest loading no-code apps around. I'm excited to tell you all about it, but first, I gotta let you know what Softr is in case you've never heard of it before. My elevator pitch for Softr would be that it's a no-code app builder for businesses, for agencies that want to provide applications for themselves and their clients without having to go to the trouble of hiring expensive developers. Now, the thing here is it works a lot like a website builder, but it's not a website builder. It simply creates apps using a very familiar interface. I released a full tutorial on getting started with the front end builder of Softr last year, so I won't go too deep into that in this video, but I do want to point out one comment that stood out. Right here, we've got Andy saying, "So you would still need an Airtable account and a Softr account. Pay for two." Now, what Andy is getting at here is that Softr was really good at the front end, but it didn't really touch the back end or the database where the information is stored. Think about it. If you've got a CRM, you're going to need to store things like the users of that CRM, who can log in, what are the names or companies that are listed inside of the CRM, what deals and what status are the deals in. These are all important parts of the application. You can't just have a pretty front end. You need the data to display to users. Traditionally, Softr has used data sources to solve this problem. You would log into your account, by the way, link in the description for that, and my thanks to my friends over at Softr for sponsoring this video. So go to data sources, connect up your data source, and they still do support a ton of data sources. In fact, they're even adding new ones. They recently added ClickUp not that long ago. But most people probably used Airtable or Google Sheets. The issue with this is syncing and slowness. It could often hit API limits, so things would need to really wait quite a while before your application was up to date. A pretty big problem. So today, Softr released a brand new feature that I am very stoked about, which we're going to explore for the rest of this video, Softr databases. Everything is now native right inside of Softr. No need to connect external databases. Of course, you can still do that if you want, but if you're on an external database and you want to bring it in, Softr has even made that possible, and I'll go through that as well. So let's dig right in. We're going to build a Softr app, and let's get started. So I'm just on a free trial here. I've got a blank account to show you everything from scratch. Now I'm going to start with a template here, but if you want to start from a purely blank canvas, you can do that as well. I think the templates are so good until you've completely mastered Softr. You should probably start with one of their templates to get some clues on how they're connecting the data together. It really is a great way to learn just by trying things out and getting your hands dirty. Now, just like I did in my first Softr video where I was focused on the front end, I'm going to go ahead and start with the sales CRM template here. I'm going to preview this. You can go ahead and look at all of the different screens that would show up in the application. It really feels just like a software as a service, you know, your own SaaS. We can preview this if we want to check it out in full screen mode and actually try using it. But I know I like this one, so I'm going to click use template. Now, traditionally, what would happen here is you'd connect up your data source. So your Notion, your Airtable, something like that. But now I don't need to do that. It's actually going to just create the database for me right inside of Softr. So I've got two main screens up here. I've got the interface, which is kind of the front end that your users or yourself as you're using your own application will see. This is the dashboard screen. I can see all of my accounts, my active deals, all of the important data that you'd want out of a sales CRM. But now in the data tab, we've got Softr databases where we can actually see a full database of everything inside of our CRM. Now, if you're not a developer, you're probably also not that familiar with databases, and you might look at this and go, well, that's a spreadsheet. I've seen those since I was in about sixth grade. What's the big deal? Well, the difference between a spreadsheet and a database, especially when you view it like this, is relational data. So I can connect up different parts of the database to other parts. And then on the front end, I can pull all of that information in and filter it out. That's a lot of words. Let me show you what I mean. So these tabs up here at the top, those are called tables. Databases have tables inside of them. They're kind of just like tabs on your web browser. It shows different parts of the web. Well, here's different parts of the database. We've got our application users. That's who can actually log into the CRM. And they're going to have a bunch of properties, right? They have different roles, whether they're an administrator or an account manager. Each person has their own profile image. You know, everything you might think about in terms of building an app, well, it's just laid out here in kind of this spreadsheet type of view. Some of the other tables that we have are contacts. So those are the actual contacts inside of the CRM. And usually contacts in a CRM also belong to a company. So there's going to be some relationships between contacts and companies. And hopefully your sales CRM is also full of deals. Now those are going to be related to contacts and companies as well. So we can see what company actually has the deal, what stage it's in, and who the main contact at that company is. Of course, you're never going to use Softr in this view. I mean, I guess you could. If you're a database nerd and you like looking at stuff in this view, you certainly could. But the power of Softr is the fact that you can build out a very beautiful and easy to understand for a non-technical person interface. So let me just show you some main concepts of the database here just to understand how it's working, right? So if we're in contacts, we've got George at Vandalay Industries, right? George Vandalay right here, and their company is Vandalay Industries. So if I go over to the companies tab and I look for Vandalay Industries, well, the main contact is George. So it's connected that way. So if I were to try to change the contact name here, I actually can't because it's coming in from the contact itself. And just to be clear, I don't recommend modifying your database directly unless you really know what you're doing. But what I can see here is this entire column is what's called a lookup column. I can tell because of the little magnifying glass here. But if I edit the field, I can see it is a lookup field. There are many types of fields available. We'll get into some more of that in a moment. But what it's doing is it's looking up the contact and then finding the name. So over in contact, we have the name field here, George Vandalay. And let's just change the name to say Kramer Vandalay. And if we go back over to our companies, of course, this updates right here from George to Kramer. Now, what I think is so cool is if you pay for your own custom CRM, there might be certain features or relationships you want to make between your own clients' data that you can't do because it's just not supported by whatever CRM provider that you're paying for. Well, not true with Softr. You can simply go into the database, add whatever column you want, and then create the relationship that you need. So over at the end here, I can add my own column. I'll choose add field. We've got a ton of different fields here we can choose from. A lot of them are just the standard fields like text or phone number, email address, things like that. But there's also these relationships here, which is really where the power of a database comes into play. So we saw lookups already. We could also do something like a related record. I've got an example of a related record for you right here. It already exists inside of the database. I'm on the activities table, and here we're going to list all of the activities that have happened in our CRM. So here we had an initial email contact. That is the activity type. The related record is it's showing who was involved in that initial contact. In this case, it was George from Vandalay Industries. Now, what's cool about a related record is that I can link to multiple records. So when I'm creating my own column over here, if I toggle this on, I could have that email go out to multiple contacts and then list them inside of the database. And then, of course, I can display them on the front end. And let's see exactly how that works. We're going to switch back over to the interface tab here inside of Softr. And I get a preview. Now, this is the builder. Like, I can actually go ahead and modify the application right here. And if I scroll down on the dashboard to, how about this section right here, my accounts. So I'm currently logged in, I believe, as Zoe down here. We can expand the dashboard here. Yeah, this is Zoe's account. So all of the accounts are going to be tied to Zoe, and here are her accounts. If I click on this, I can see what exactly is going on or what Softr is doing to pull this information up. We've got our database source over here, which is going to be a Softr database. I could connect up to Airtable and link up multiple sources inside of one application if I want, but I'm not. I'm going to stick with Softr, and then I'm going inside of the sales CRM database that it created for me, and I'm looking inside of the company's table. Those are all of the same tables that we just saw, those tabs at the top of the screen. Now, here is where it gets cool because we're not just displaying all of the companies, right? We want to see my accounts, the ones that I manage. So if the account manager includes exactly is what the setting here is, the user's email address, right? So it's the logged in user's email address, then it's going to display them over here as these cards, which by the way, you can change how those look as well. All of the content that is displayed, all of the styles, everything is completely customizable. This is truly your own application. Now, if I want to see this in a little bit more detail, I can open up a preview here before hitting publish. It's just going to pop it open into another tab and I can preview it as a specific user. So this is what the full CRM is going to look like. Now, the really cool thing here is that, again, the database is baked right into Softr now, so there's no waiting for syncing. Everything is blazing fast. If you update something inside of the database, we don't have to wait for it to go out to a third party and do an API call to come back in. Really, really cool stuff. So I'm logged in as Alan. Let's say I've just got a new lead. I'm going to add them in as a company. I'll choose add company. I can enter in all of the information here. And when I go ahead and hit add, it's going to show up instantly inside of my database. So here is my new company. And if I just jump right back over to Softr Studio, go into my database, under companies, I've got the Minnesota Twins right there. Everything is instantaneous. All right, so this is all well and good for new users of Softr because they can get started from scratch with their own database. But what if you're already using something like Airtable or Google Sheets? What can you do? Well, good news there as well. You can import your data directly into Softr. So here is my Airtable account. This is actually the account that I used to create my first video on how to use the front end builder of Softr. I can export this data and bring it directly into Softr, and that way I don't have to connect up Airtable anymore. To do the export, just go ahead and choose the little triangle up here next to the view that you're looking at, and then it says download CSV. I'm gonna do that right now. And then over in Softr, I can go to databases and I can import my data right here. Now, if you wanna add data to an existing database, you can do that as well. But first, let's just import data as a brand new database. So I'll click import your data and I'll choose CSV file. Notice they hint that direct importing from Airtable and Google Sheets is coming soon, but for now, CSV works great. All right, so I've selected CSV. I'm gonna continue to the next screen and I'll simply drag and drop the newly downloaded file right into the drop zone. Here we go, I'll drop it in. It lets me preview the data to make sure everything is as I suspected and I'll choose import data. And there we go, I've got a brand new database with all of the same information. But remember, this was only the employee view that I downloaded. I wanna get everything in. So we're gonna do this process one more time and I'll show you how to import data to an existing database. Now, first of all, let's get things cleaned up here. So I'm gonna name my database. I'll call it Airtable Import Demo. And my table came in as employees, all employees. So let's rename that as well. Now, next I need to add in a brand new table. So I'll click this plus button. And now I can either create a blank table or just import from CSV. Now, before I do that, of course, I've got to export it from Airtable. Now, there's really no reason you can't just do all of these at once. So go over to your next table, deals, download the CSV, then go over to contacts, rinse and repeat. You know, most of your databases probably are not going to have more than a dozen or so tables. So this really will not take very long. You can see I'm almost done and I'm just chatting away as I do it. All right, I just got my last table. And now over in the Softr database, I will import from CSV. I'll drag in my deals here, import the data. And again, just kind of rinse and repeat importing from CSVs for each individual table. Here's my contacts. And I just went ahead and imported the final table, the accounts table. Now I've got all of the information from Airtable over inside of Softr, but there's still a problem in that all of the relationships between the data is broken. Everything was imported table by table. So if I wanted to really utilize this in the same capacity, I'd have to create the relationships across all of the tables. And that will definitely take a little bit more time. So if you're in that boat, it might be worthwhile just waiting until the official Airtable integration is ready, but maybe you just have a small subset of data that's in a CSV and you want to utilize it inside of Airtable, in which case this feature works great. So now just so you can see, I've got my apps over here. This is going to be that front end design. Here's my sales CRM. And now I've got two databases, the sales CRM, which is being utilized by that app, and then the new database I just created. I haven't built anything with it yet, but I'm free to do so using their front end builder. All right, what do you think about no-code app building? I really think it is the way of the future. Have you built anything? Are you curious about building anything? Leave me a comment down below. My name is Dave. If you've enjoyed this video, hit that like button. Check out my Softr link if you want to get signed up for a free trial. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.